What is going on, guys? This is Daniel. And prior to the draft, Marvin Bagley's defense was his biggest concern. And we had an opportunity to watch him in Summer League for a few games to see his defense in a different setting than Duke. So let's get to Bagley's defense. Let's start with Bagley's face-up and post-up defense. And face-up defense is an area he definitely lacks polish in. And here, for example, after Mo Wagner puts on a few nice moves, he gets turned around and has to goaltend. Notably, he had a bad habit of opening up to one-on-one drivers. Here, for instance, he opens up to Derek Jones, giving him the baseline instead of squaring up. He was probably trying to prevent Jones from going middle, but it gives Jones a straight line drive and a score. This time against Wagner, he opens up, here allowing Wagner to go middle, and he also falls for a brief pump fake. On the bright side, Bagley did look to consistently front the post on duck-in situations. So here, for example, against Adebayo, he looks to front him, and Adebayo is still able to get it here and then shed Bagley, pushing him backwards, partly because Bagley is not very strong yet, but Bagley recovers and contests the shot. This time, Bagley fights to get in front of Aiden on the duck-in and is able to get the steal as well when a bad pass is thrown. Now let's talk about Bagley's rim protection and help defense, which I thought was pretty solid. Here, for instance, he's very prompt on the help, rotating over with his hands high, and the ball handler passes it. This is really good anticipation, so he contains the ball in the pick and roll, and then on the skip pass, he immediately realizes that he'll need to be the primary help defender on the drive, so he'll rotate over and step up on the drive. That being said, on this particular play, he actually was probably better off not helping so early. I thought the on-ball defender was in decent position to cut off and contain the drive on his own, and the fact that Bagley did step up so soon helped the Suns get a good shot, but still, that play was a positive indicator. This was a nice job by Bagley on the fast break to keep his arms up and not foul against Josh Hart. In terms of his rim protection, it doesn't seem though like he has verticality down. Here, for instance, a nice job of stepping up on the help, but instead of jumping straight up and taking the contact into his chest using verticality, he jumps to the side and ends up fouling. He was very prompt to protect the rim, but it was nice to see him show good judgment on this play. He steps up to help and is ready to jump to contest, but at the last moment the Lakers guard passes it off and Bagley is able to stay down and recover to his man. The other thing that was impressive was Bagley's timing on blocks in Summer League. He doesn't do a good job of hauling in the rebound here, but he makes up for it by timing the block well. A bit of miscommunication on the top here, but Bagley protects the rim by high pointing the ball and blocking it. For a 19-year-old, his help awareness and general defensive awareness didn't seem to be bad, but of course it can be improved. Here, for instance, there's a switch where Adebayo is now being defended by Frank Mason, and the smart play would be for Bagley to execute an off-ball switch and take Adebayo while Mason scrams to the weak side, but no switch is executed and Adebayo is able to post up Mason. Here, when the Heat push the ball, it definitely looks like Bagley should match up to the guard on top, but he doesn't and the guard gets an open three. Now let's move on to pick and roll defense, where Bagley struggled a bit, mainly because he left the ball too early when he was containing. So here, for instance, the Lakers guard performs a hesitation move, and that causes Bagley to recover to the pick and pop too early before Frank Mason had gotten back in front of the ball, and that gives up the drive. He certainly had pick and roll defense instances where this didn't happen, but it happened far too often, and here's another example where this time in a drop he leaves the ball too early, especially considering he had weak side help on the roller Aiden, and the Suns get a layup. And this was just bizarre how he completely allows a straight line drive to the basket, way too worried about stopping the roller Aiden. Coaching will help fix that defensive problem, though it wasn't great to see him do that in the first place. And in the pick and roll, I also expect his strength to hurt him, especially early in his career. And here Josh Hart is able to lower his shoulder and get a good look against Bagley. Let's talk about his perimeter defense, which is definitely a bit raw, and here defending a player on the perimeter, he overhelps, which we saw earlier. So Giles does a good job on the switch to keep the ball contained, yet Bagley steps over to help off of a shooter, though give Bagley credit for hustling, running Wagner off of the line, and then recovering for the block. He'll have to work on his closeouts a bit, and here he overextends on a closeout, giving Jones the drive. Though in transition, this was a better closeout. He'll hustle on the skip pass and then use his lateral quickness to keep the ball in front. Overall, his perimeter defense is definitely a positive because he does have that quickness and potential as a switch defender. And while in Summer League he wasn't really asked to switch, the few times he did end up on a guard on top, he held his own by keeping the guard in front, and here he nicely forces a step back. Lastly, let's talk about defensive rebounding, and especially if he plays a bunch of five, he'll get beat up a bit inside because of his lack of strength, and here we see him get pushed under the rim and he gives up the offensive board. Here on a free throw, he gets pushed in a bit and the Suns keep possession. On the bright side, he's not super skinny, and he also does a good job of pretty consistently boxing out. Here's an example as he locates Wagner. At least in Summer League, he had a pretty high defensive motor, and here before the shot is even taken, he's already looking to box out Aiden to keep him off the glass. And if he's defending someone on the perimeter, which he'll do a bunch if he plays the four, he'll add a lot of value as an athletic gang rebounder. Here, for example, he comes over and helps take the ball away from Aiden, helping his teammate out. Well, there you have it, guys. Bagley is an athletic finisher who currently lacks offensive polish in areas such as posting up and shooting threes, and his defense needs fine-tuning but has potential in that area. Two big questions are, can he add a reliable three-point shot? Because the sooner he does that, the easier it will be for the Kings to play him at the four. And also, how much does he improve his defensive fundamentals and feel? And to answer the question of the video, do I think Marvin Bagley's defensive concerns are overblown? I wouldn't say overblown because the issues are real, but I will say I'm more optimistic about Bagley's defense than most because he does try hard, his instincts aren't broken, and he does have potential as a switch defender who adds rim protection. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.